This lyrically gifted hip-hop artist recently made another impressive jump into acting. He has already been on Soul City, and now he's on Muvango, one of South Africa's biggest soapies. Ladies and gentlemen, for the second time on Late Night with Khumutso, here's Zulu Boy!
How are you doing?
I'm good.
It's been a while.
Yeah.
So how did this part in Muvango come about?
I got Usisi, we're legends.
Right.
Lisa gave me a call. She's like, Zulu Boy, would you begin to do Muvango? I'm like, all right, cool. And we went in there with Tupida Mazibugo from Alive. People know him from Alive. Went in there to audition. The audition started at 9 next scene.
Okay.
And it was for Uspa. Iphathe Dlala Uphile.
Okay.
From 9 in the morning, we was a shyana, and 200 people knocking on one skin. We knocked each other away until there was just two of us left.
So it was like Survivor Muvango.
Survivor Muvango, you know what I mean? Ubabu Duma was very tight with that one. And then we were left, and Uphila was this character who played, and when I played vice versa, his role, I was like, you know what I mean? So Ubabu Duma really liked the two characters, the way we played them. So he made a friend for Uspa, which was Vora, the character I played. So he took the both of us that were left there behind.
Unbelievable, hey? You know, I don't know if people, the first time we met was at the Blues Room.
Yeah.
You were an MC.
I was just a rapper, and she gave me a call and asked me if I'd be interested in acting, and look where I am today, yeah?
I don't want to take credit for it because I knew you
it's
had it.
It's no credit. Take it.
But
take it.
Thank you. But the point is, I knew it was obvious to me. It was just like, he would be perfect for Zakes. And I was just praying, like, please, Lord, don't let him suck. Please, Lord, don't let him suck. And you did it. So there you were.
Thank you very much.
Only a pleasure. Only a pressure. So listen, so you've got this character on Muvango, but you also pray. My goodness. Hey,
I do.
It's
as a reminder that I need to go and give another Thanksgiving to the
family. So must you always have this smelly goat around?
Yeah, it's the West. The Western world always have turkeys, but she's ama turkey, la piminandos, every Thanksgiving, and they feed their family.
Turkeys?
Yeah, ama turkey for Thanksgiving. Turkey? Thanksgiving?
That, do they? Okay. Yeah. You mean the Americans?
The Western ways,
okay.
You know? So, I mean, as a Zulu guy, you know, I pretend to my Thanksgiving with lembus like Melifies, but you know what I mean? Yeah. So, it's the goat, and I get the skin, and I get to feed the whole village instead of just the family.
But the thing about what people don't understand about sacrifices, traditional sacrifices, it's not easy to kill an animal.
It's not easy, man. It's...
And it's not the most pleasant thing, and you don't like, there's a whole process around.
There's a warrant for my arrest. I've killed so many goats.
Have you? Yeah. Does it become easier?
Yeah, it becomes one of those fulalenta mo boy, let it paga it boy, let him burst. Gone, pa. And it becomes quicker, so it's painless. You know what I mean?
Like, I thought I was going to try and make us like, no, we don't just kill the animal. We commune with the animal.
No,
we communicate with the animal.
I watched Special Assignment once. These guys who farm chickens, they went there with iron tips now. The chickens we eat. I was watching that on Special Assignment. But then the same people that slaughter cattle and slaughter sheep at butcheries and the meat we buy in Woolworths or whichever Pick and Pay or Spar Shop, right? It's the same procedure. We just
at the end of it, the animal dies. So whether you're holding it by the horns or
putting it in a machine,
you're doing it humanely with something, it dies.
It does.
Okay, let's talk about something more pleasant.